security staff to reinforce gates, showing how the British retooled their prized bastion to control the Irish instead.
Being on guys,
with fortified high walls and excellent observation and lookout positions, that also made this site ideal to be a prison.
In 1916, when the Irish Republicans rebelled against British military rule, the imperious star-shaped fort proved invaluable.
During the Irish War of Independence, this site was brought back into use again as a prison. The sun roads have changed very little since then.
This was where the convicted Republicans were killed. This would have been their living quarters, their sleeping quarters, their dining quarters, their recreation quarters.
There was some pretty serious tension between these prisoners who had fought on one side and the guards who were their enemies.
Obviously, there was friction. These were being veterans that had been attempting to kill Concord.
The famous revolutionaries who came through.
You lost your toy.
Rings around the British.
There was one particularly important individual here with the British, and his real name was Conway. He made the name for himself attacking and destroying our device. He was very near the top of the Concord's advantages. And he was arrested in
Malone was a commander in the Republican Islands. He was once described as Ireland's Houdini when he escaped this fortress jail.
Hi, Gus.
Helped by the prison's Catholic chaplain.
And you're helping, Gus. Thank you.
His comrades had to remain inside until Irish independence in 1921. But modern cells.
Hi, Louie.
And partitions suggest Spike Island's role as a prison wasn't yet over.
In 1985, the fort was again used as a prison, but a civilian prison. There had been a space of increased traffic, so Spike Island was opened up again to absorb some of these extra inmates.
This time, it was the Irish themselves who put the prison fort to use.
This area was converted into modern cells in 1985. There were 35.
Thanks, Kaz. You're really helping out here.